Alpha Male Bible. Unlock the future potential in you. Learn leadership strategies and tactics to excel in life and love relationships by learning pack leader psychology. Written by Aron Pattinson. Narrated by Tim Evans. Introduction. From birth, men experience stereotypes. Think about it. Baby boys wear blue. Little boys play with cars and trains, then grow up to play with Legos and video games. You hear it from your parents and friends growing up. Then you start to see it reflected in the TV shows and movies you watch. Men have to be tough. Men don't back down from a fight. Men should be able to work with their hands. Men are the providers. Men can only have certain careers. It could feel suffocating to hear and see these stereotypes for your entire life and realize that's not you. Or maybe part of it are you and others aren't. You like the color blue, but you've never been in a fight. You like to cook and prefer to keep the house cleaner than your female partner. Does that mean you're not a true man? No way. Stereotypes are unhealthy, and studies have been done in hopes of changing society's approach to these narrow-minded judgments. After all, women are subject to stereotypes too, but it seems society accepts them, breaking out of their box more willingly than they do for men. An Australian study was conducted where the participants were men aged 18 to 30. The Jesuit Social Service Men's Project in 2018, the researchers created a man box, highlighting 7 key masculine stereotypes, then asked for the participants to discuss the problems surrounding these stereotypes and how it was reflected in their own lives. These 7 stereotypes include self-sufficiency, acting tough, physical attractiveness, gender roles, heterosexuality and homophobia, hypersexuality, and aggression and control. Self-sufficiency means men are expected to solve their own problems, whether they're emotional problems or real problems. Men aren't supposed to ask others for help with personal issues, and they definitely shouldn't have to call a mechanic if they get a flat tire. Society expects men to figure out these problems on their own. Acting tough is self-explanatory. People expect boys to act tough from childhood and beyond. Men are always supposed to fight back if someone threatens them. They should never show they're scared or anxious, and instead should react with their physical power. Physical attractiveness is a shallow stereotype, because people expect successful men to be attractive and attractive men to be successful. But if you spend too much time focused on your looks or grooming yourself, you're deemed not manly enough. Go figure. Gender roles restrict both men and women from birth and beyond. Men are expected to be better at math and science than women and are encouraged to follow related career paths. A career is important because men need to be the providers for their families. They should go to work every day and leave their wife to do all the household chores. If a man doesn't want to get married or waits until he's older to marry, that opens another can of worms. This leads us right into heterosexuality and homophobia. Gay men are not seen by society as real men, and manly men shouldn't be friends with gay men. Similarly, if a man doesn't marry by a certain time in his life, people may speculate it's because he's gay. Much of this is a problem because men are expected to possess hypersexuality, which means he has as many partners as possible. Society sees men with more sexual partners as more desirable, more powerful, and more manly. Many of the factors listed above play into this final stereotype as well. Men need to be aggressive and in control. They should always be prepared to use violence to protect themselves, their dignity, their partner, or their family. They should always be in control, which seems to be at odds with using violence to resolve problems, but typically refers more to being in control of their lives. They should always be the head of the household. They should be the ones who start or end a relationship. Their word is the be-all, end-all, and all women, children, and weakest men should defer to him. Being a modern man, it's easy to scoff off these stereotypes and admit how ridiculous they are. You might have experienced some prejudice because you don't fit into this unhealthy man box. But just because you're enlightened and in touch with yourself doesn't mean society is accepting you. Almost half of the men in this study acknowledged that they had learned how to be a man based on those 7 unhealthy stereotypes. Remember, these participants were age 18 to 30, so it's not like they grew up in the time when men smoked cigars in the hospital waiting room while their babies were born. These are modern men too, and these stereotypes are still perpetuated by society. On the plus side, around 70% of these participants disagreed with the stereotypes, which shows that attitudes about masculinity and alpha males are changing with young men. If younger men can accept these changes and demonstrate them in their own lives, others will feel more comfortable doing the same. Then, even more, the next generation will grow up embracing new norms and hopefully have fewer stereotypes to compete against until all the negativity has been eliminated. In this book, you will learn about alpha males in terms of what qualities they possess that you can benefit from in a healthy way. You'll learn how to build your confidence, not to intimidate others, but to feel good about yourself. You'll learn how to become a leader, not to be the man in control, but to showcase your knowledge and skills, especially in the workplace. You'll learn how being true to yourself can help you look attractive to women, and learn how to maintain a relationship beneficially for both you and your partner. It might sound like much of this book focuses on how you can become a better person to help those around you, but there's more to it than that. Self-care can also help you become the best man you can be, and there's an entire chapter dedicated to how you can take care of yourself. The goal of this book is to help you be true to yourself while creating new norms that will debunk the harmful stereotypes you've grown up with. Chapter 1. What is an alpha male? Alpha males are typically defined as the man at the top of the social hierarchy. They're the ones who command all the attention. Men want to be them. Women want to be with them. They're powerful, and this might make them seem intimidating, yet enticing. Alpha men are thought to be manly men, those who embrace the stereotypes previously addressed and now thought of as harmful. Beta males, on the other hand, are seen as weak or submissive men. They're the ones who constantly work, but never seem to get ahead. They're too timid to ask for promotions. They only get the women alpha males cast off. They're single until women decide they're ready to find a nice guy. While these definitions originally started in the animal kingdom, they've come to apply to humans as well. Both definitions are harmful because neither man is a good person if you take a step back to analyze them. It's hard to define people in such broad terms, and doing so leaves out so many intricacies of who they really are. Yet people do it every day, and it harms everyone. Being pigeonholed can make you feel like you need to double down on who you are, especially if you're labeled an alpha male. Or you might feel like you need to change everything about yourself to get ahead if you've been labeled a beta male. In reality, shouldn't there be a balance of these traits? Expecting one man to be the ultimate...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.